In galvanic cell, two beakers are there, right? So this is the first beaker and this is the second beaker. Now, this first beaker is having electrode. This electrode is zinc, which is dipped in its own ion solution, that is zinc sulfate. Now, here zinc is electrode, right? And this zinc sulfate is electrolyte. So, the zinc is dipped in the solution of its own ion electrolyte, that is zinc sulfate. Now again, there is another beaker which have copper electrode and which is dipped in the solution of its own ion, that is copper sulfate, right? Now students, this is the half cell. The first one is called half cell, right? And this again is called half cell. Now see, suppose this cell is losing electron and this cell is gaining electron. So is it a complete cell? क्या ये complete cell है? यहाँ पे एक half cell बताया है मैंने, जो lose कर रहा है electron, and there is another beaker which in which electrode is gaining electron. So this is a complete cell. Just think, the answer is no. Reason being, if it's lose electron and if gain electron, then they must be a source, they must be a path from which electron can move from this beaker to this beaker. So this will become a complete cell only when we connect it with the help of wire, when these two electrodes are connected with help of a wire. So this is a wire. So if this electrode lose electron, then electron will flow through this path and it will move towards the next electrode which can gain electron. Here this is either ammeter or voltmeter. Okay, in order to measure the potential, you can use voltmeter. In order to measure the current, you can use ammeter. Okay, so now this two half cell makes a complete cell. So let us again study that galvanic cell consists of two beaker. In first beaker, zinc electrode is dipped in the solution of its own electrolyte, that is zinc sulfate, and copper. In second beaker, the copper electrode is dipped in the solution of its own ion, that is copper sulfate. Now these two beakers or the two electrodes are, so according to activity series, the elements which are present at the top of activity series are most reactive metals, right? And as you move down to the activity series, reactivity decreases. So if you compare, then zinc is above copper in activity series. So zinc is more reactive metal in compared to copper. So because zinc is more reactive, it have tendency to lose electron, and because copper is less reactive, it have tendency to gain electron. So students, for this topic you have to go through the reactivity series, and the reactivity series we will also study later on in this chapter also. Okay, so for now just keep in mind that metals which are present at the top of reactivity series are more reactive, and which is present at the bottom of reactivity series are less reactive. And if you compare zinc and copper, then zinc is more reactive, so it will lose electron, and copper is less reactive, so it will gain electron. Therefore I have written over here oxidation. So zinc undergo oxidation process, whereas copper cell undergoes reduction process. Therefore the first half cell is known as oxidative half cell. It is known as oxidative half cell. Okay, and this is known as reductive half cell. So students, just keep in mind that two beakers are connected with the help of wire, and in the first beaker, in the first half cell, oxidation reaction take place. Therefore it is known as oxidative half cell, whereas in second beaker, second half cell, reduction take place. Therefore it is known as reductive half cell. Okay, so let's see how the reaction take place in these two beaker and how electron flow which result into the generation of formation of or production of electricity. So in first cell, what happened? Zinc metal is there which act as a electrode, right? So this metal will lose electron and it will form Zn2+, Why it will lose electron? Because we have already stated that zinc is more reactive in compared to copper, so it will lose electron. So it will lose 2 electron and it will form zinc 2 plus. Right? Now this zinc 2 plus will move into this solution, that is into electrolyte, move into electrolyte. Right? And this 2 electron will move towards cathode. Will move towards the cathode. Now this reaction is taking place at anode, right? Because you know that when we have studied about the fabrication of cell, I repeat it, when we study about the fabrication of cell, we have taken these two electrodes which were connected with the help of wire, right? This electrode is known as anode, which was made up of copper. Right, this electrode is known as cathode, which is made up of copper. Right, this is made up of zinc and this is made up of copper. Now students, see, this is negatively charged electrode and this is positively charged electrode, and trick to remember this is lone, l-o-a-n. On left hand side oxidation take place, that electrode is anode and negatively charged, so left hand side oxidation will take place and it will be anode and that too of negative charge. So you can see that this is left hand side, here oxidation will take place, we have already studied, and this is anode and negatively charged, right? And this is dipped in the solution of its own electrolyte. Understood? So students, what happened over here in this zinc electrode undergo oxidation process and it will lose 2 electrons. Okay, now these 2 electrons, what happens to it? These 2 electrons will move from anode to cathode. Will move from anode to cathode, and the zinc ion which is formed, this is solid zinc, when it converts into ion, it will move into the solution and it will form zinc 2 plus. So the zinc 2 plus will move into solution and the electron will transfer through this wire towards the cathode. Okay, so at anode what is happening? At anode oxidation is taking place, right? So zinc is converted into 2 plus and electrons are releasing from this particular electrode. Now this electrons will move towards the cathode, right? So what reaction will take place at cathode? You know that at cathode reduction take place, at cathode reduction take place, right? We have already studied about the reactivity series, that cathode is made up of copper and copper is less reactive, right? Copper is less reactive, so copper will gain electron, so here reduction will take place. Okay, now from solution 2 plus ion, from solution 2 plus ion, this is the neutral copper, and the in this solution 2 plus copper is there, so from solution 2 plus copper ion will combine with 2 electrons which are transferring from this anode towards the cathode, and it will convert into neutral copper. Neutral copper. Okay, so here you can see that neutral metal convert into metal ion and metal ion convert into neutral metal. So just keep in mind, whenever any ion is generated, that ion will be present in solution. Okay, and whenever any solid form is there, neutral form is there, that will be considered as solid. For example, here zinc is neutral, so it is solid. Again, here copper is neutral, so it is solid. In this, zinc ion is present, so it is liquid state. It means solution state. And copper ion is, again, it is in solution state, right? So you can see here that whenever any ion is present in ionic form, whenever any metal is present in ionic form, it will be in solution. Right, and if it is in neutral state, it will be in solid state. So let us conclude once again. Here at anode oxidation will take place, so this zinc will lose 2 electron which will move through this wire and will move towards the cathode, and the 2 plus zinc 2 plus ion will move into the solution. So reaction will be zinc will be converted to zinc 2 plus and 2 electron will be released out. Now these 2 electrons will move towards the cathode, and over here these 2 electrons will react with the copper 2 plus of the solution of electrolyte and it will convert into copper. Okay, so we can conclude that in simple, what is happening over here? At anode, zinc is converting into zinc 2 plus, plus 2 electrons are moving out, right? At cathode, copper 2 plus will gain these 2 electrons and convert into neutral copper. Understood? Now students, you can see here, this zinc is converting to zinc 2 plus. It means this electrode is getting dissolved with the period of time. With the span of time, this zinc will be convert into zinc 2 plus. It means it will convert from solid to liquid state. It will move into the solution, right? So with span of time, what will happen? With span of time, this electrode will start degrading, dissolving. So this zinc will convert into zinc 2 plus ion and it will move into the solution, right? Now here, with the span of time, what is happening? This copper 2 plus is gaining 2 electron and converting to copper. It means with span of time, this electrode will become thickened up. So here deposition will take place and here dissolution will take place. With span of time, ये कम होती जाएगी और ये thick होती जाएगी. So here dissolution is taking place and here deposition is taking place. So this is all about the reaction, oxidation and reduction, which is taking place in this reaction. Okay, so let us conclude that we can say that in galvanic cell, two beakers are there in which the electrodes are dipped in its own ion solution, and these two half cell are connected with the help of wire, right? And on the left hand side, oxidation will take place and that electrode will be anode and negatively charged. It means, but obvious, on right hand side, reduction will take place, that will be cathode and it will be of positive charge, right? So when at anode, oxidation will take place, two electrons will be lost and metal ion will be formed. This metal ion will move into the solution, right? And these electrons which are loose during this process will move towards the cathode, and over here the ion which is present in the solution will gain electron and it will form neutral metal. So in short, we can conclude at the end that with a span of time, this metal will start degrading and this will become thickened up. So this is the simplest form, you can say, you can explain this particular phenomena, right? So let's move to the next topic of the same. Students, you have already studied about the fabrication of electrochemical cell, but that was not a complete fabrication, right? If you remember, in that we have taken two beakers. This beaker were having electrolyte. This is the zinc electrolyte. I will write over here. This is copper electrolyte. Copper electrode. And in this, zinc sulfate is there. In this, copper sulfate is there. Right. Now and these were connected with the help of wire. Now with the span of time, if you remember, then over here, zinc will convert into zinc 2 plus and 2 electron will be released out, which will move towards the cathode, and here the copper 2 plus which is present in the solution will attract this ion electrons and it will convert into copper, right? This was the reaction. So students, if you remember, then in this, what is happening in the solution? Zinc 2 plus ion concentration is increasing. Zinc 2 plus concentration ion is increasing with respect to time, right? And in this solution, we can say that copper 2 plus is decreasing, or you can say that in comparison, SO4 2 minus is increasing, right? So in short, we can say that in both, what is happening in both, electrically imbalance is taking place. Here zinc ion is increasing, here sulfate ions are increasing. So here the ion imbalancing is taken place, and because of this ion imbalancing, cell will stop functioning. So in order to maintain the electrical neutrality, these two cells are connected with the help of salt bridge. we use salt bridge to make our solution of cells electrical neutral, right? So in this concern, what we do, we will study about the salt bridge, right? So students, what happened over here, salt bridge is used to combine these two solution. This is the salt bridge, which is the inverted U-shaped tube containing, it is a inverted U-shaped tube which contains the concentrated solution of inert electrolyte. Electrolyte, like, it may have KCl, it may have KNO3, or it may have K2SO4, etc. So in this inverted U-shaped tube have concentrated solution of electrolyte, inert electrolyte, for example KCl, KNO3 or K2SO4, right? And the end of this salt bridge is plugged with the cotton. Right, in order to prevent the flow of this particular electrolyte. Now students, in this U-shaped tube, this electrolytes are used, and this electrolytes are mixed with the agar-agar gel. So this agar-agar gel is combined with this electrolyte in order to make them inert, and this particular paste is filled into this salt bridge, or this paste is used to make this salt bridge and filled into this U-shaped tube, and this, the terminal of this U-shaped tube is plugged in with the help of cotton, right? Now students, what happened, you know that suppose, for example, it is made up of K2SO4, for example this salt bridge is made up of K2SO4, so what will happen in this, you know, over here zinc ion are in more amounts, right? So over here this is positively charged, so over here the sulfate ion from this salt bridge move into this solution, right? And in this way it will neutralize, the zinc ion will combine with SO4 negative, and in this way it will neutralize the solution. And over here you know that sulfate ions are increasing because copper ions are decreasing, right? So because sulfate ions are increasing, over here the K plus ion of this electrolyte will move in towards the cathode, right? So it will form K2SO4. Again it will neutralize the solution. So the salt bridge help in the maintaining the electrical neutrality. So if you talk about the fabrication of salt bridge, then salt bridge is made up of inverted U-shaped tube which is filled with the concentrated solution of inert electrolyte, that is KCl, KNO3, K2SO4. Now these electrolytes are mixed with agar-agar, and then they are filled into this U-shaped tube, and the terminal of these tubes are plugged with the cotton wire. Now so because over here Zn2+ is increasing, so negative ion of this electrolyte will move towards the zinc 2+, and here SO4 negative ion is increasing, so K positive will move towards this SO4 minus. In this way this salt bridge will help to maintain the neutrality of both the solution and will increase the lifetime of the cell. Okay, so this is the salt bridge and functioning of salt bridge. So in short, what is the role of salt bridge? Salt bridge help in the maintaining the electrical neutrality. Okay, so let's move to the representation of cell. How you can represent the cell? Now let's move to the topic, representation of cell. How can you represent a cell? So students, you know that in galvanic cell at anode, what will happen? Zinc solid metal will convert into zinc 2+, that is it will convert in aqueous state, and 2 electrons will be released out. At cathode, what will happen? at cathode, this copper 2 plus, which is in aqueous state, will react with these two electrons which are moving from anode towards the cathode, and it will help in the formation of copper, which is again in solid state. So if we make a net reaction, then cancel out this two electron with this two electrons. So on reactant side we left with the zinc and copper 2 plus. So on reactant side, right, zinc solid plus copper 2 plus aqueous. Now nothing is left on the reactant side, so make a arrow, and at product side you are left with zinc 2 plus and copper, right? So write zinc 2 plus, which is again in aqueous state, and copper, which is in solid state. So this is the net equation of galvanic cell, right? Now if you want to write the cell representation, in that case what you will write, A B C. This is a trick. A B C. A stands for anode, B stands for salt bridge, C stands for cathode. So at anode you know that a zinc is converting into zinc 2 plus. So write anode, at anode zinc is converting into zinc 2 plus. Right, and you have to write a slash in between this. This shows the interface. Interface means this is solid and this is aqueous. So this is the interface between solid and aqueous. So this is the interface sign, right? Now salt bridge will be represented by double dash in this way. Now you know at cathode what is happening? Copper 2 plus is converting to copper. So write copper 2 plus is converting into copper. Again interface, because this is aqueous and this is solid. This is aqueous and this is solid. So this single slash shows the interface, that is phase between solid and liquid, right? And this double slash represent the salt bridge. So in this way you can represent the cell. So first you have to write about anode, and then you have to write about cathode, and you have to put the symbol of slash and double slash in between these equation, where slash represent, single slash represent the interface, and double slash represent the salt bridge. Okay, so this is all about the representation of cell. This is reaction at anode, this is reaction at cathode. If you sum up this equation, you will get the net equation, and from this equation you can also find out the representation of cell. And this is the salt trick, A B C. I hope you understood this topic, right?